Good morning. Black History Month is upon us. For many of us, this is the month that we celebrate Black Americans in our past who fought for the equal rights of all people, and especially people of color. I'm here to tell you that the tireless fight for equality is far from over. On behalf of the Early Learning Center staff and students, we welcome you to our 2020 Black History Program. We'll have Dr. Porter, the Chair of Teacher Education. She'll come out and give us the greetings.
Good morning. On behalf of the Department of Teacher Education, where I serve as the department chair, I bring you greetings. The Early Learning Center is an integral part of our work here in the Department of Teacher Education. Our faculty and staff are involved with our baby rams, and our college students are involved with our baby rams. We have completed science days, math days, social studies days, and reading days at the center. We also have faculty on the PBIS team. Mrs. Barney and I speak often about the happenings of the ELC. The baby rams teach us just as much as we hope to have taught them. These 2, 3, 4, and 5-year-olds are our future. Even though we can look to the future, we cannot forget about the past. These young people are here to celebrate Black history, their history, our history, this nation's history, and everyone's history. The faculty, staff, and our baby rams have prepared an outstanding program, and I'm sure we will all enjoy it. I recall a saying, "Train up the child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it." These young people are the representation of the future of Albany State University. May blessings be upon each of them and each of you. Thank you.
Can we give Dr. Porter another round of applause, please? Thank you, and up next we have the Pledge of Allegiance by our very own ASU Little Queen 2019-2020, Skylar Gervin and Dwayne Johnson will be holding the flag today.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of Washington, America, to the pleasure in which you stand, one nation, under God, with the beautiful and vicious ambition for all.
Thank you, Skylar and Dwayne. Next coming up, we'll have Mr. Aiden Walton. He is our 2019-2020 Little Mr. ASU.
The faculty, staff, and students of ASU Early Learning Center welcome you to our Black History Program. We have learned a lot and hope that you enjoy and maybe learn something too.
Thank you, Mr. Aiden. Up next, we have our 2-year-old class presentations. In that class for this year, we have Ms. Sharon Brown and Ms. Shayla Brooks. Sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Good morning. I'm Ms. Brooks from the 2-year-old classroom, and today they want to put on a little fashion show. They'll be dressed like historical figures in Black culture. All right, our first little model is Miss Savannah Poole, dressed up as Dr. Mae Jemison, the first African-American woman to enter space.
Hello.
All right, our next model is Mr. Shavis Jackson, dressed up as Layston Hughes. He was one of the most important writers and thinkers of the Harlem Renaissance. Say hey, Shavis. All right. Next up is Miss Jalasia Whitlock. She's dressed up as Miss Flo Kennedy. She left a vibrant legacy as one of the leaders of the Black Power and feminist movement and often photographed in a cowboy hat. Her little pink hat on. Okay. Carson Williams is our next model. She is dressed up as Mary Eliza Mahoney. Mahoney was one of the first African women to go to school and become a nurse in the United States. Say hey, Carson. Moving right along to Mr. Dwayne Jackson. Mr. Dwayne is dressed as Dr. Charles Drew, the American surgeon who helped develop techniques for blood storage. Wave, Dwayne. He said no. Okay. Olivia Wilson, our next model, is dressed up as Miss Constance Baker Motley. She was the first African-American woman to become a federal judge. Oh, look at her little gavel. Wave, Olivia. Okay. Miss Lena Elbaudry. Come on out. She is modeled as Mary Church Terrell, a key pioneer in the intersectional movement for civil rights and suffrage. Come on, baby. Her pretty dress on. Okay, Miss Amber Davis is dressed up as Nikki Giovanni, one of the most important historical figures in African American culture. All right, Amari Cooper is dressed up as Miss Zozibi Tunazi, 2019 Miss Universe. Wait, okay, Miss Riley Howard is dressed up as Miss Toni Morrison, the very first Black woman to win a Nobel Peace Prize. Wait, Riley. Okay. Last is Nyla Dawson, dressed up as Miss Phyllis Wheatley, the very first African American woman to publish a book. Wave, Nyla. Okay.
Can we give the twos a round of applause? And next, we'll have our two-year-old class. They're going to perform their dance. Thank you, too. Next, we have our three-year-old class, and in that class is Ms. Shambrika Williams and Ms. Mary Hampton. They're going to present the Black history figures from the past and present.
Good morning. Welcome to our red carpet modeling show here at the unsinkable Albany State University. We are here this morning to honor African Americans who played a key role in shaping our history. First, we have Martin and Coretta Scott King. Years after the assassination of Martin Luther King Jr., the world continues to search for peace and equal rights. But over the course of his life, King helped lead that charge. Always by his side, either physically or in spirit, his devoted wife, Coretta Scott King. On June 18, 1953, 16 months after they met, Martin and Coretta were married by Martin's father, Daddy King. Before his assassination in April of 1968, Martin and Coretta settled in Montgomery, Alabama, and had four children together. They also began to build what is now a well-documented legacy of using nonviolence to effect legislative change for disenfranchised Americans across a range of backgrounds. The foundation of that legacy rests in a special bond that began in 1952.
I was an American author and a leader in the civil rights movement. I was the wife of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. We are Martin and Coretta Scott King.
Next, we have Simone Biles, born Simone Arianna Biles on March 14, 1997, is an American gymnast with a total of 30 Olympic and World Championship medals. Biles is the most decorated American gymnast and the world's third most decorated gymnast. At the 2016 Summer Olympics, Biles won individual gold medals. Biles began her career at the age of 14 on July 1st, 2011 at the 2011 American Classic in Houston. Biles is well known for her performance of difficult skills at a high level of execution.
And my best.
Next we have Miss Rosa Parks. I guess Miss Rosa is taking her time. Miss Rosa Parks, born on February 4th, 1913, as Rosa Louise McCauley, was an American activist in the civil rights movement, best known for her role in the Montgomery bus boycott. Congress has called her the First Lady of the Civil Rights and the Mother of the Freedom Movement. On December 1st, 1955, in Montgomery, Alabama, Parks refused to give up her seat on the bus. Her act of defiance and the Montgomery bus boycott became important symbols of the movement. Her bravery led the nationwide efforts to end racial segregation. Parks was awarded the Martin Luther King Jr. Award by the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People and the Presidential Medal of Freedom and the Congressional Gold Medal. She died on October 24, 2005 at the age of 92. We are Rosa Parks.
It's okay. All right. It's okay. You okay? Okay.
Next, we have Barack Obama. Okay, Mr. Barack Obama. All right, Mr. Barack Obama. Hush, Andrew.
I am Barack Obama.
Well, Mr. Barack Obama was born August 4th, 1961. He served as the 44th President of the United States from 2009 to 2017. Next, we'll have Malcolm X. Born Malcolm Little on May 19th, 1925. In 1946, he joined the nation.
I am Malcolm X.
In 1946, he joined the Nation of Islam and changed his name to Malcolm X. Malcolm X Day is celebrated in various cities and countries worldwide, and hundreds of streets and schools in the U.S. are named in his honor. He has been called one of the greatest African Americans in history. Now we will have Miss Ruthie Mae Harris. Ruthie Mae Harris was born and raised in the Good Life city of Albany, Georgia. Her parents were Reverend Isaiah Harris and Katie B. Harris. Harris was devoted to the movement and organized the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee here in Albany, Georgia, known as the SNCC. She was one of the SNCC's original freedom singers in 1962. Ruthie Mae was arrested more than once and on occasions assaulted. In 1963, before the thousands of people gathered at the March on Washington, she sang. Harris played a huge role in not just Albany history, but worldwide. As a faithful member of the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, she remained focused on using her music to educate about civil rights.
I am Ruthie Mae Harris.
Next, we have Hank Aaron. Born as Hank Lewis Aaron on February 5th, 1934, he's a retired American Major League Baseball right fielder. He played 21 seasons in the National League and 2 seasons in the American League. He held the Major League Baseball record for career home runs for 33 years. He now serves as the Senior Vice President of the Atlanta Braves. He is Hank Aaron. Next, we have Bernard Harris Jr. Born June 26, 1956, in Temple, Texas. He is a former NASA astronaut. On February 9, 1995, he became the first African-American to spacewalk during the second of his 2 space shuttle flights. He was also the first African-American man to go into space as one of NASA's research teams, and he was involved in the construction of space rovers.
I am Bernard Harris Jr.
Next, we have Venus and Serena Williams. The Williams sisters are 2 professional American tennis players. Venus Williams, born in 1980, is a 7-time Grand Slam title winner. And Serena Williams, born in 1981, is a 23 Grand Slam title winner. They became the first two players, female or male, to play in 4 consecutive Grand Slam singles finals. Both sisters have been ranked by the Women's Tennis Association at the world number one position.
We are Venus Serena Williams.
Next, we have Mr. Joseph Winthrop Holly. Mr. Holly was born in Winnsboro, South Carolina in 1874. He is best known as the founder of Albany State University, which he founded in 1903. He served as the school president from its inception until his retirement in 1943. Next, we have Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson, born August 29, 1958. Jackson was an American singer, songwriter, and dancer. Dubbed the King of Pop, he is regarded as one of the most significant culture figures of the 20th century and one of the greatest entertainers in the history of music. The 8th child of the Jackson family, Jackson made his professional debut in 1964 with elder brothers as a member of the Jackson 5. Jackson is one of the best-selling music artists of all time. He won more awards than any other artist in the history of popular music and has been inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame twice. Jackson died from cardiac arrest on June 25, 2009 at the age of 50.
Okay, he don't want to do his dance, friends. You want to do your dance?
I am Michael Jackson.
And last but not least, we have Ray Charles. Mr. Ray Charles Robinson, born on September 23rd, 1930, here in Albany, Georgia. He was an American singer, songwriter, pianist, and composer. Charles pioneered in the soul music during the 1950s by combining blues, rhythm, and gospel styles into the music he recorded. Charles' 1960 hit, Georgia on My Mind, was the first of his 3 career number one hits. Ray Charles passed away June 10, 2004, at the age of 73.
I am.
And this concludes our red carpet modeling show.
All right, great job, Threes. Can you give them another round of applause, please? Next, the Threes will do a skit.
Sing about Martin.
Sing about Martin.
Sing about peace.
Sing about peace.
All around the world.
All around the world.
Sing about Martin.
Sing about Martin.
Thank you, threes. Okay, we'll have our pre-K class, and in that class we have Miss Dolores Luke and Karen Hall.
Every February, America observes a special occasion called Cowboy History Month. This observance serves as a time trying to celebrate the accomplishment of African American. In 1926, Dr. Carter Godwin Woodson, other African Americans with white scars, launched Negro History Week. In 1976, it was expanded to become Black History Month. Now it serves as a time of as a tribute who have graced our country,
As a tribute to the many African Americans.
Who graced our country's history.
Yay, Antonio. Good job. Go right out there, stand in front of it.
History loves on. Today is the day we all sing in honor of Martin Luther King. Where every people fought to be free, his name is remembered with dignity. When black people weren't treated right, he stood up strong to lead the fight. He fought with love, not guns or darts. He changed people's minds and their hearts. But some people didn't like his words. He was taken away to a better world. Yet history lives on, that all can be free, and knock down the walls between you and me. Martin Luther King's life did not last, but his dream and his spirits are free at last.
I serve as the 44th president of the United States of America, 2009 for 17 years weekend. I'm Barack Obama.
Jesse Jackson is an American activist and minister and politician. He was the Democratic presidential candidate in 1988 and 1984.
Shirley Tajan was the first black woman to run for president.
I am strong, I am gentle, I am proud, I am humble, I am confident, I am beautiful, I am intelligent, I am becoming all that I can be. I am Cameron Michaela Poole, I am a child of God.
Ruby Bracy was the first African American. So was he, our white elementary school. Yeah.
Go to the back of the bus for the parts. Go and stay. I think that's unfair. I'm too tired today. Everyone knows the blue rosy part. Everyone knows if you're black, you can't eat in white restaurants. And on buses, you sit in the back.
Rosa Parks, I think it's time to go, Rosa Parks. No, I won. I have a voice, and everyone will hear the call.
We're coming to sit with you, Rosa Parks. People black and white did say we're coming to change America and bring equality here to stay.
They venture, create something new with material.
America is better. Lion Johnson was America and Silver Water guy.
Roger McCoy was a mechanical engineer. He invented the lubrication cup so the train will not have to stop to get oil.
America did it for the you never heard it made who were horror in the family Mary saw what the time was say he would have to be and tell her what he do the end. He was he wanted to know where the right up and down. These hoes you peel meal, like peel butter, peel oil, peel deer, peel washing, peel bar, and other peel honey. And he needed for he had there for more. He wanted for you whatever, and he was happy to share with your head.
I am an American writer, producer, and comedian. I'm Tyler Perry, better known as Medea.
Morgan Freeman, June 1st, he's an actor, film, and writer.
I am Gibson Rochester Jr. And I have Cameron, actor, producer, asu-tv, Kimberly, Golden Wolf, Paddleport, the actor.
Kobe Bryant was an American basketball player. He played his 20-season career with the Los Angeles Lakers.
Gotta remember, keep it up to your mouth, okay? Put it up to your mouth. Go out there.
I am Jesse Robinson. I play Major League Baseball.
Say it again.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, go ahead.
I am Jesse Rossi. I play Major League Baseball.
Very good. Good job.
Thank you. Give us a round of applause for our pre-K students. Next up, and finally, they'll present their song.
Cool. I can see this right here.
In small towns, in big cities, you came together as Democrats, Republicans, and Independents to stand up and say that we are one nation, we are one people, and our time for change has come.
I believe.
Thank you, pre-K. Can you give him a round of applause, please? Thank you all for y'all constant support and coming out to see our baby Rams. And we thank you from the ELC staff and the Early Learning Center students. We thank you, thank you, thank you.